Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. How are you guys doing today? A warm welcome to one and all. This is Ashok Devanampriya. I am the CEO of Traders Gurukul and Stratazon Nalgo Trading Company. Friends, on behalf of Traders Gurukul, I'm extremely honored to welcome every one of you to Intrazon 2.0, India's largest retail traders online conference. I feel privileged to see thousands of people joining us every day. From the past three sessions, the participation rate has been very good. Probably the theme is a crowd puller because the theme is exclusively intraday. Pure intraday models would be discussed over the period of 12 days. My sincere thanks to colleagues, management, and leadership of Money Control Pro for joining us as media partner and believing in our ability to deliver great conferences for traders and investors. Let me also take this opportunity to appreciate our title sponsor, Espresso, the Sher Khan company, one of the leading discount brokers in India, for joining us on board. The speaker for today is my very good friend, Vishal Mehta, CMT. CMT is chapter chair of Mumbai. He is the chapter chair for Mumbai. He has experience with all kinds of technical and fundamental aspects and information. He worked in companies like Spider Software, Reliable Software, Financial Technologies, Thomson Reuters, and Bloomberg. He has been one of the successful traders whom I know personally. I feel it's a privilege and honor to have Vishal as my good friend. I am equally good critic also for Vishal. He has automated most of his trading systems and allocates some fund for investing through rule-based systems. His title for today is Smart Straddle Intraday Strategy. So my friend Vishal, on behalf of Traders Gurukul, Money Control Pro and Espresso Families, I extend my warm welcome to you into this program as an elite speaker. Go ahead, my friend. It's your turn and the stage is yours.
Thank you, Ashok. Thank you very much. And I really want to thank Espresso and Money Control Pro and obviously Ashok and the team who has done a fantastic job of bringing this education, because I always believe the education is the first step for your growth. Because a lot of, to start a trading, the easiest thing is to just open up a Demat account and you can become a trader. But we all know that how hard it is to become a trader and make a living out of it is even more difficult. So that's where I really wanted to, congratulate you of making this awareness among the community. So let me start with my presentation. I will just share my screen. Just let me know if you are able to see my screen right now, Ashok. I'm going to go on a presenter mode.
Yes, perfect.
Awesome. So, hey, good evening, everyone. It's 8 o'clock and I really want to congratulate you as well for taking time out on educating yourself for one of the most difficult concepts in the trading that we always talk about is the intraday trading. So let's start. So the topic of the strategy today, I'm going to talk about smart straddle, or you can call it triangle or whatever, as Shakespeare says, what's in the name, okay? Well, because I got lot of points, like, why do you call it straddle? Because the way the structure of the strategies, it can be strangle as well. It's not the point. It's about how smart you can look at from an intraday strategy perspective. And I'm going to talk about it. Just before that, just a disclaimer. I'm not a SEBI registered investment advisor or a financial advisor. Whatever the trades that I'm recommending is just for the presentation and educational purpose only and does not constitute buy and sell. Obviously, you should only raise the money that you can afford to lose. And thanks to SEBI, a lot of risk and regulations that has come recently, a lot of deleveraging has happened in the market. And the most important point, although we are going to discuss about a strategy, my idea is not to give you a strategy. My idea is to give you a platform to build your own strategy. As we know, that if you just copy paste anyone's strategy, will that work? Think in your mind. Answer is no, because what we have seen that if the strategy is not yours or if you have not built the foundation, or if you have just started to copy paste it, the minute it goes into a drawdown, you have not lived that strategy. And there is a high probability that you will stop using that strategy. And that's why I just really wanted to open up your mind about just not doing standard straddles and strangles, but how you can get more innovative. And this innovation for us came through our own experience. We traded ourselves, made money, lost money. And when we lost money, we didn't stop there. We tried to figure out why did we lose money and what we could have done to at least minimize the loss. See, nobody can reduce the loss or nobody can eliminate the loss. The trick is always try to reduce the losses and how it is going to come into your comfort zone. So with this, I think Ashok has given a nice background about me that I worked everywhere. So I run a blog called as Market Scanner. You can definitely go and check out, because where we put a lot of ideas, new in you know, trading strategies and everything which can be of help to you to build the foundation of your strategies. I've been across Asia. I've been to, like, I never knew there was a central bank in Maldives, and I was called in Maldives to do training on technical analysis. So I'm very happy about it. I'm a co-chair for CMD, and I'm trading my young trader as well. Hopefully she'll become a good trader. I always get this question from my colleagues all the time. Vishal, you've been in the market for a longest period of time. What really helped you as a trader? And few of the books that I would definitely, you know, kind of highlight to you. If you can see a book named as Trade Like a Casino, that had a good impact on my mindset. The book that really turned me from a discretionary trader to a systematic trader by books by Larry Connors. And this was the book, How Markets Really Work. And in that book, the author talked about, you know, edge. And I was alien to that word. What is an edge? Edge is nothing but your probability of win in the long run. And he was talking about 0.15, 0.18%. The highest he talked about, if I remember, was like 0.2%, 0.5%. And here I was looking at M2M screenshots of the biggest of the big traders. And this guy runs a hedge fund who talks about 0.5, 0.8 edge. And that surprised me. So I said, okay, what is that guy, this guy's talking, trying to talk about? And that I started trading my journey. And by the way, this is my Amazon Kindle book. I actually read the ticks that you can see are the books that I've read. So whoever said that trading is easy is either lucky or is lying to you. It's not that easy. CMT, on the other hand, really helped me a lot to become a better trader, because it put the thought process, it put the right structure to learn about the concepts on technical analysis and meeting the trader. I'm sure you would have met with a lot of the traders. I got an opportunity to meet with this Mr. Gentleman, and that gentleman is the founder of MACD, Gerald Apple. Okay, he founded the MACD. And when you go and meet him in New York, he talks about how the market functions, how he sees the market. If you're a technical analyst, you would have definitely read a book by Martin Pring. Nobody can, be exaggerating a situation that you cannot be a technical analyst or call yourself technical analyst unless and until you read about Martin Pring. I got an opportunity to interact with him as well. JC Parrott, brilliant guy, no nonsense technical analysis, simple support and resistance, and he's bang on. And this gentleman that I'm standing along with him, the same height as me, was Tony Saliba. He was the only option trader featured in Market Wizard book. This was the Market Wizard book that really helped me. Whenever I'm in a drawdown, I just pick up a Market Wizard book and start reading through the chapters. Tony Saliba, there is a chapter called as One Lot Trader, and he actually traded one lot, only one lot, throughout the 1 year till he became comfortable with the system. And sometimes for us, we looked at an strategy on a webinar or anything, and from the next day we start with 10 lots, 20 lots, 30 lots, and once we have a small loss, we just abandon the strategy or maybe blame the trainer or anything of that sort, but never blame ourselves, because yeah, it was a strategy, it was working in the back test, why it should work in the future as well. But that's not how things work. Tony Saliba traded the option for 1 year, only one lot, till he got comfortable. So that's how it is. So yeah, Ashok.
Yes, sir. So friends, the title sponsor for IntraZone 2.0 is Espresso, a Share Khan company, one of the well-known discount brokers in India, who don't charge for your losses and only charge when you make a profit. More details in the subsequent sessions. Thank you.
Very interesting. So it's good to know that brokers are looking after us when we are actually making a loss. So that's good. Thanks, Espresso team.
That's quite good, no?
Yes. And most of the time as a trader, we are right only 50 to 60% of the time. So most of the time we are paying brokerage when we are losing. So it definitely adds up to our kitty of a P&L. So that's good. Thanks, Espresso team.
So there's only one point to make here. See, the problem is most people think this broker is like a hafta vasuli person. Okay. That broker is eating a lot of money. But fact of the matter is the brokerage is the most smallest component of our cost. People don't even consider STT slippage, which is lot more money. When we expose them to reality, they'll be wondering, oh, really? I never knew. I always did brokerage is high. Brokerage is never a big cost for us.
And also remember, if a broker is giving a platform, there is a cost associated with it. So I always believe that if you're not paying for your brokerages, then you are the product. So yeah, if they are charging, it's good, but it has to be reasonable. So yeah, thanks. So now coming to how do I go about building a strategy, and I have talked about in all my numerous presentation, for many of you would be the repetition, but many of you it will be something new. So I will take that liberty of going through this presentation again, because I'm a trader, I don't make strategies every day. For teaching, I trade some of the strategies that I trade. So I don't have every new strategies every week or every month. But always remember this. When you go about building a trading strategy, you should have a fundamental philosophy of why that should work. And that should be an extension. I still remember speaking to Atul Suri, who used to work with Rare Enterprise, Mr. Rakesh Jhunjhunwala. And we had this candid conversation, where he said, and which was beautifully ingrained in my mind, that a trading strategy should be an extension of your nature. I'm going to repeat it. And that's his word, not mine. Okay. A trading strategy should be an extension of your nature or your style. What do I mean by that? I'm a kind of a guy who always believe, when I read a lot of books, and one book really dented on, like, you know, in a positive way, was Rich Dad Poor Dad. And we as an individual or a middle class family were taught that never spend too much. Okay, always Hindi mein bolte hai ki apni chadar jitni utna hi pair phailao. To quote it in English, just, you know, spend as much as you can earn. But what Rich Dad Poor Dad book told about, never think about that way. Think about it, if how can I afford it? We use this word, I cannot afford it. And I always, you know, got really inspired that how can I afford it? It's the word, just a change. I cannot afford to how can I afford? And that's where my fundamental philosophy was. So even if I go to buy a camera, and I was just speaking to Rajiv, one of my good friend, and we bought a Logitech Brio. Usually people tend to scroll the Amazon from lowest price to the highest price. I tend to do it differently. I actually put the ascending order or descending order from the price. That means the highest price camera should come up. And I actually bought the highest priced Logitech Brio. And that was my style, because I always want to think that how can I afford the costliest thing and work backwards. And same thing translated into my market observation. And where Ashok said, I will buy the stocks which are making an all-time high. Okay. Lot of people, fundamental analysts or technical analysts, may get worried that, you know, why would you buy a stock at an all-time high? And in my belief system, I'm again repeating, in my belief system, and my dad once told me that Infosys was trading at 12 rupees and it went to 12,000 rupees. It cannot go from 12 rupees to 12,000 rupees by making a 52-week low. It has to make a 52-week high or an all-time high. The thing that can come your mind, take all-time high if I would have bought it, and what if I got stuck? And that's where this third part of the risk management comes in. Build rules with risk management. So you had a rule that I'm going to buy something at an all-time high, but does not mean that I'm going to just sit like a sitting duck to be shot down. I'm going to have rules. I'm going to have a rules to entry. I will have a rules to exit, and I will have rules to trail my stop losses and the risk management. Once I have those rules, I'm going to backtest those rules. And once that backtesting shows me some positive result, I'm going to talk about strategy optimization. Now, a lot of traders think that strategy optimization is bad. It's counterfeiting. And a lot of people don't understand the difference between the two words. Counterfeiting and optimization. Counterfeiting, let me just give you an example. If I'm going to take a two moving average crossovers, okay, say 520, and it is a profitable strategy, okay? But what if I'm going to do 421? The P&L should be just near about 520. It should not have a